क्या आपको भी मैथ से डर लगता है? क्या आपको भी लगता है कि आप कैट क्लियर नहीं कर पाएंगे क्योंकि क्वांट्स बहुत टफ है? वेल, आप अकेले नहीं हैं। यहाँ ये बैठी लड़की, ये नारी भी मैथ से बहुत बहुत ज्यादा डरती थी, एंड दैट वॉज अ वेरी वेरी बिग रीजन वाई फॉर द लॉन्गेस्ट टाइम आई केप्ट थिंकिंग दैट आई वोंट बी एबल टू क्लियर कैट। एंड हियर आई एम टुडे एन MDI गुड़गांव। आई एम वेरी हैप्पी इन माई जॉब, एंजॉइंग माई लाइफ, एंड अबाउट टू शेयर विद यू वॉट आई डिड टू ओवरकम माई फियर ऑफ मैथमेटिक्स। सो प्लीज कीप वॉचिंग। हाई गाइज, वेलकम बैक टू माई चैनल द MBA गिनी पिग। I am Urvashi Jain, a recent MDI Gurgaon alum, and as you know, I make videos on everything MBA, how I prepared, my life at MDI Gurgaon, and things I've been doing after passing out. Today's topic is very, very requested, that is, mujhe quant se dar lagta hai, and therefore, I do not know how to begin with my CAT preparation. So guys, the very, very first thing that I would share with you is I've made a video on this topic before. Maybe a lot of you might have already watched it. Still, I'm going to link it in the description box below and put a teaser above. Why? Because the points that I'm going to discuss today are more on the lines of what were the factors which helped me overcome the fear, whereas that video was more about exactly how did I study to overcome the fear. So slightly different videos, and I would seriously recommend to go and watch that video as well. Now, the very first thing which I keep hearing from a lot of you is that I left mathematics after my 10th standard, and therefore I'm not very sure if I'll be able to clear CAT. While I had mathematics up till my 12th standard, and I had mathematics in my graduation as well, I would say that the mathematics which is covered in 11th and 12th standard is very advanced, and that is not what comes in CAT quants. I'm not saying that quant section in CAT is easy. All I'm trying to say is it's very arithmetic, which is the maths that you do up till your 10th standard. So definitely, if you've done mathematics up till your 10th standard, which I'm sure all of you have, because that is the kind of education system we have in India, CAT is not going to be a problem with a lot of practice put into it. The next point which I have to clarify is, now it does not matter which coaching classes I join. I know a lot of you have been asking this question for like almost a year now, and I never answer, and I'll answer it today. Why is the reason I never answer this question? So basically, looking back, I am convinced that the coaching classes you join don't matter as much as the schedule of the coaching classes. So the thing is, like, I scored a 95.8 percentile, which I know isn't great, but the thing is, it got me some very good calls, and it got me into MDI Gurgaon. Similarly, you know, my sister studied from a different coaching institute, and she also got a similar percentile. So it was proof enough for me that the coaching institute does not matter. What matters is it accessible for you? So for example, the coaching institute, I joined the same coaching institute twice. When I was in my final year of graduation, I decided to prepare for CAT, and I joined a certain coaching institute which was close to my college, and I had to attend it in the weekdays after my college. And I started to notice that I've been bunking so many classes. Eventually, I just decided that I want to get a campus placement, and I went for a job, and I completely gave up on CAT. Whereas the second time when I prepared for CAT, I ensured that I go there on weekdays, but during the mornings, and it was close to my home. So the medium was convenient to me. Now, why am I mentioning this point in a video about CAT fear, quant fear? Is because actually, this is very, very important. You're scared of a subject, right? And that subject is really pulling you down and not letting you believe that you'll be able to clear the exam. And on top of that, you increase the complication of taking some kind of coaching, which is in itself a challenge. Ye school nahi hai. I know when you're young, your parents are so centered on the fact ki hum apne bachche ko best school mein dalenge. Things don't really work like that when it comes to coaching institutes. More or less, the medium remains the same. What really matters is the professor's style clear to you? Second, is it accessible? Will you be able to join it and actually maintain going to the classes regularly? So the ease of the format is what matters the most. That is one thing which really, really helped me in my preparation the second time that I did it. But I would definitely say joining a coaching institute helped me for the simple reason that I was in a schedule. I was in a batch, and therefore I had some structured learning going on, which kept me on a timetable and on a time leash that I have to prepare this or the class would be ahead of me the next time I go there. So in that vein, I would definitely say that join a coaching class. I know, I've not forgotten ki lockdown lagi hui and corona chal raha hai, but I've also got a solution to that. This video is actually sponsored by Unacademy Plus. So Unacademy is a platform where they have a lot of online classes and they have these batches running online. They are live classes which you can take a subscription to on Unacademy Plus, and therefore even though there is a lockdown, you actually have the advantage of joining a live online batch, and that batch would run for a duration of 3 to 4 months. And if you take a course subscription on Unacademy Plus, you use the code UJMBA for a 10% discount on it. Then moving on to the next point, practice it out. Now, what a lot of people do is they will literally just follow the coaching. That is also not the right way to do it. I knew I'm scared of the subject, and so I need to put in extra hard work towards this subject. And I made sure that every day, 3 to 4 hours of my day, apart from the coaching, I was practicing once. And the reason was, if I've done a certain topic in the coaching, it's all fresh in my mind for that day. So I wanted to ensure that when I come home, I practice that topic from, you know, my material, so that there is one less thing to be scared of the next morning that I wake up. So definitely hard work is the only way out. One other thing about my practice was, there was no single day when I only practiced quants. I always made sure that I do a little bit of DILR or a little bit of VARC along with quants. Reason being, now quants is a subject that I'm really scared of. So I don't want the day to be very heavy, and therefore a series of such days would then become very demotivating for me. So your case might be different. For me, VARC was a lighter subject. I enjoyed doing VARC. So I would always practice a little bit of VARC in between the day to kind of keep myself going and keep myself motivated. That is also one serious advice that I would give you. Now, the fourth point that I would discuss over here is, and I've discussed it in my other video in quite some detail, but I will mention it very briefly over here, is learn speed mathematics. So if you just put in basic effort in practicing the mathematics that you've learned up till the sixth standard, that is literally your tables, your squares, your cube roots, your cubes, square roots, it is going to take you a long, long way in your CAT prep, because all of these chapters that you study for your CAT prep require arithmetic. And if you're good at basic arithmetic, you will just be so much faster when the professor is solving all of those questions. So I would definitely say that keep your speed mathematics really strong. There are a lot of speed mathematics resources online. So please YouTube it, please Google it, and start to learn these tricks. I literally learned it on my own. I learned speed mathematics on my own, and it really helped me going forward. So that is one thing which I did to overcome my fear of quants. Another thing was that I really tried to identify my strengths. So what happened was, for all of you, there will be certain subjects which you like, and there will be certain subjects which you recognize that I'm usually not very good with these concepts. And how are you going to identify the difference is by practicing. So I was also practicing a lot of mocks. So many of my classmates made these mistakes that they were like, I'm going to start solving mocks when I'm done, you know, solving all of the topics, otherwise I feel very demotivated when I sit for the mocks. Yaar, apni ego cat exam ke liye bacha ke rakho. Mocks is not the time when you should be scared of not knowing. It's completely okay that even if you know only 2 questions in that paper of 30, it's all right. That's because you've only done 2 subjects, 2 chapters. But the point is, just because you're reading 30 questions, it starts to make sense when those chapters, you actually take up those chapters. Reason being, a lot of questions and quants are interrelated when you sit for CAT, and therefore you should be very clear ki do teen subjects saath mein bhi kaise use honge. Ek aur one very big benefit of solving mocks right since the beginning is, you keep practicing the chapters that you've done in the past. So you never lose touch, you know, it's not like you move to the next chapter and you've forgotten the 3 you did before. You're constantly giving mocks, you're constantly brushing up your skills. So that is one, like, I literally have friends, you know, when I joined MBA, I realized that so many of my friends have literally given mocks. That was their only study material, and still they cleared the exam with very good percentile. Reason being that mocks are also like a textbook. All kinds of questions are there in the mocks and you really, really need to solve them. I'm also going to link a video in the description box where I've talked about how to attempt and solve the mocks. So please go through that video. I genuinely feel that that video is going to help you and get you started ki mocks ko kaise treat karna hai. And I'm also going to put a teaser up over here. So us video ko bhi zarur se refer karna. The very last point that I have to share with you guys is you've decided to give CAT, right? And agar tumhe lag raha hai ki quants ke wajah se CAT clear nahi ho payega, then in my opinion, you're not yet decided. You're still stuck on an if or but kind of a situation. In my case, I was 100% determined that mujhe CAT dena hai. So mere paas wo option nahi tha where I keep fearing the subject and I don't do anything about it. Alright, so put yourself in that situation. Dena hai matlab dena hai. One more thing which I have to say is, it really helps to have the realization that is this not the last challenge or the toughest challenge you face in life. Maine quant seekhi, then I went to MBA, maine statistics seekhi. Job life mein bhi itni sari cheeze hai jo main seekh rahi hu, mujhe bilkul nahi aati thi. So this is going to go on. Life is going to keep throwing challenges at you and you have to, you know, if you have to be a manager someday, that is what you aspire for. Learn to take up challenges and life is going to be sorted. So yes, definitely get started guys, okay? And please keep leaving comments below as to what other videos you want to watch and I'm going to try and make more and more videos on prep as well. Bye bye. Best of luck.